Hi there, my name's Tyler Ring, president of Hilleshög Seed. I'd like to welcome you to Longmont, Colorado. This is our seed processing plant here in Longmont. Today we're going to take a look at our facility, basically from beginning to end, the product coming in one door and heading out the other. So come on in and let's take a look. Now inside our seed processing plant here in Longmont, Hilleshög has been part of this facility since really the mid to late 80s. We've had numerous expansions and investments in this facility. A big one in the late 80s, we had another one in the 90s and into the 2000s. I'm going to walk through the facility and kind of give you a breakdown of how seed comes into it, right to processing, propelling, the building of the seed, the treating of the seed, and then right to the finished goods, out the door, goes on the way to the customer. So let's take a look.
All right, the beginning of the multiplication process in seed production really starts with Steckley Nurseries. Our company has two main Steck nurseries that we utilize. We have one in the California area. Typically, planting will begin in the September time frame, and we try to shoot for harvest to happen in January. And then we also have a Steckley nursery in Salem, Oregon with West Coast Beet Seed. Planting happens a little bit earlier in the August time frame, and we shoot for a later harvest. February is typically when harvest occurs there. We try to focus on is about 120,000 stecks per acre is really the target, what we're looking at. As the stecks progress from a growth point of view, we try to shoot for that optimal size during that January and February, depending on where we're at. The process happens where we will go and defoliate, we will mow down. We don't want to damage the crown because we're going to certainly utilize those healthy stecks at a later point. We have a mechanical harvester that will go in and undercut the stack. We'll harvest those stecks, we'll eliminate some soil at that time. We do harvest those into bins. And then from there, we take the stecks across the soil eliminator. And at that point, we're looking at reducing some of the dirt, soil, debris, some selection at that time where we want to look for the proper stecks, those that are healthy and so forth. And then the California stecks are put into a cooler and transported up to Oregon to be used at a later time. Oregon Steck Nursery. That remains a little bit different process that happens up in the Oregon area. Similar, but stecks are really harvested. There's typically more manual activities that take place, and you're going from harvesting the stecks directly right into transplanting activities. So you do not have the soil eliminator and some of the cooling activities that take place in the California Steck Nursery. All of this is in preparation for the commercial crop, which then will be transplanted in that January to February timeframe, with the hopes to have a successful harvest in the fall time of the year.
Our tour today is going to consist of really three main areas. We're going to talk first about the conditioning of the seed when it arrives from West Coast Beet Seed. Second part of the tour is going to entail the building and treating of the seed. And then the final part is going to be the packaging and really the shipment of the seed out to our customers. Our seed is grown in the Willamette Valley of Oregon. So the seed is grown there, it's pre-cleaned there, and then it's shipped to Longmont, Colorado. We start the process right here. Seed is delivered into the facility here and is brought through our process with weighing, barcode activities. We start the process of sizing the seed at that time. After our tri-walls are dumped, they are elevated up to this level on conveyors and brought into storage containers. wheat is, after it's elevated, it's brought into the storage bins. It's segregated into the different bins by different fields. So we have the ability to set the different hybrids by field per bin at this stage. And then it starts our next process, which we'll go into now. All right, next step, our seeds is brought over to our sizing machine. And this is where the raw seed is sized into the different seed sizes of small, medium, large, and extra large seed. It is then brought back down and elevated back up. It is collected into different bins for a short time and then brought over to the gravity table. And the gravity table is where we are, in essence, we're trying to get the pure and best seed at that point. So the heavier seed that really is the most dense and has the best embryo is collected at that stage. After our seed is sized up above us, it's brought down to, which is arguably the most important part of the seed plant, is the gravity table. Our gravity table, the importance of having the seed sized is really you're looking and trying to have that uniformity on the table. And here's where you're looking at the density of the seed and trying to capture the seed that has that full embryo and the ability to have the heavier type seed or your lighter material that has the empties. This is where the importance of having strong seed men and women running these machines to ensure that they have the right fit and the right feel to ensure that they're making the proper cut. How much seed you're throwing away and really trying to capture that pristine seed that will take us to the next level. Our seed is now conditioned. We're on to the next step. We send our seed up to West Fargo. It is primed with the folks from Germain's. Priming does several things. It washes the inhibitors off the seed, but it also helps improve the speed of the seed. So it's in essence starting and stopping the whole germination process. And then it's brought back to Longmont for our next step.
The building stage, you know, I think the first thing to mention is really the powder that we're using. This is a proprietary blend of a soft wood powder that we are using on all of our seed. What we do is we have both a wood mill formulation, but we're also adding Apron Max fungicides within the pellet itself. This is mainly used to combat some of the diseases that are out there, Rhizoctonia, Fusarium, some early stage diseases, damping off some of those challenges that the grower may face. So that is all done within the building stage. A key thing when building seed is really to have the appropriate time that you run this within your rotostat. Building it too fast, you could have a packed pellet, so it could be more of a tight pellet that could challenge some of the germination factors, or you could do it too slow, and that certainly could challenge some of the integrity of the pellet itself. So there's really a timing on based on the density and the size of the seed of how long you put that particular seed in the rotostat to build that pellet. After the pellet is built, it is moved on to our dryer. We've got a fluidized bed dryer that we run this, and it's basically to take moisture down out of the pellet. It's again to help improve the integrity of the pellet. At that time, you know, size coming out of that, your pellet is typically a little bit bigger, so drying it down will reduce size to some extent. And this is done via batch, so depending on how much seed, how much volume, how much weight is ran through, it determines how long it needs to go through the dryer. After that process, we run it through our selectors, which this helps target what is the right or ideal pellet size that we're after. Is it a 4M, is it a S2, whatever the case may be. and we have a process using, you know, round and slotted screens that we have overs and unders at that time that we're taking out as we move through the, you know, we call it the end of the blonde stage. It's brought into totes, and then we bring it back through the rotostat to start the treating process. And what the treating process is really based on what is the target chemical application that you're looking for. Whatever market you're trying to hit has a set of fungicides or insecticides and the colorant that a recipe is put in place to put the appropriate grams per unit based on the ideal end product. That is the next step where we are running it through a rotostat. Chemical is put on the outside of the pellet, and we do that to try to keep that as far away from the seed as itself. So once we're done with that process, similar to the pelleting, we bring it through our dryers and we put it back through our selectors to look for those overs and unders, and from there we have a finished pelleted / treated product that's ready for the quality aspect, but also if it does meet quality, then we are on to the next step, which is the packaging.
We do a battery of tests all the way through the process. So once the seed is brought into Longmont, we're testing it really at every different step along the way.
Understanding our seed quality is critically important through all the different steps of our business. Our company puts a lot of emphasis on testing our seed numerous times throughout the different stages. We do different tests throughout it. You know, purity test is one aspect. So we're looking at weeds, inert material. We're looking at different trait purity tests that we put in place to make sure that the Roundup Ready is viable within our seed, but also looking for some traits that maybe not wanted in our seed lots. Testing our seed for those as well. We do numerous grow outs where we're looking for reds, chards. We do some bolter testing as well to identify lots that might be sensitive to bolting. We've got the standard germination of 4-day and 7-day that is required, and also look at bigger testing and stress tests to really challenge the seed and see what the seed can do in adverse conditions, as well as understanding how the seed is reacting to some of the chemicals that we were putting on it, our insecticides and our fungicides, and doing some soil testing as well. So all of these are taking place and other tests that we put in our practice to make sure that the best quality seed is put in the box, and we understand this throughout the beginning right to the final end as we ship the seed out to our customers.
Okay, so part of our quality process is to understand the plantability, and we're using some of the old technology, we're using some of the new technology, where we're looking at an eye to capture the seed drop, to look for anything in regards to doubles, skips, things of that nature. So this is something that is pretty important to our end customer to ensure that they've got a good quality product that not only comes out of the ground, but the plantability is critically important to ensure that we've got the best start from the beginning. Okay, one of the key things within our system here is how we handle the seed and how we know where the seed is and what seed we're working on at all times. What we have here is barcoding. Barcoding is done right from the beginning, where we bring seed into the Longmont facility at the other end of the building. That is shot, and it allows our team to understand what it is, and really goes through our operating system as well, that they can do a production order based off the next level in line. But more importantly, it helps them understand what they're working on, and allows us to have no mix-ups or no errors or things of that nature. We always know what we got by shooting the barcode and being able to understand where it's at and at what stage the seed is in.
The next step in our process is the packaging line. We package our seed into basically two different areas. We package it into boxes where we have two different size boxes, but both have the amount of 4 units per box. We've got a small box and a larger size box. And then we also have the ability to pack seed in a tote. This can be specialized to meet the grower's needs to a certain level, but typically we plan around 96 units, the standard amount that we put in the totes, but it can be specialized according to the need of our customer. From there, our seed is then moved over and palletized. We shrink wrap it, and we get it ready for the next stage, which would be the finished good area of our warehouse and get it ready for shipment to our regional warehouses or to the customer directly.
All right, after our seed is packed, we will then put our seed in the finished package area. From there, it's the next stage, is we're getting the seed ready for shipment out into the marketplace. We will ship this seed, depending on market, to the Michigan, Red River Valley, Idaho, Western Sugar Markets, Canada. It usually goes to our regional warehouses and then on to our dealers and on to our end customer. From there, seed is held in the marketplace. It's delivered, depending on market, end of February, really through the replant season of April and May. And then we bring seed back. Whatever is not sold or planted, we will bring that back into Longmont, typically in that mid to late June time frame, and really start the whole process over again. Well, thank you for joining us today on the tour. We appreciate spending a little time with you. You've been a proud supporter of the ASSBT for many years. We hope you guys have a great conference and look forward to being a trusted partner in the sugar industry. Thank you.